about the national movement in the last days. So before that one, today's topics, before starting of the today's subtopics, sir, just we'll be going to have a glimpse that what are the previous subtopics we haven't discussed. The very first we haven't discussed about the national the arrival of the Mahatma Gandhi from South Africa in the year 1915. From the 1915 he has been visited from India, then participated in the local movements, then having a get with the role at that, then we had Janiyan Wala Bagh massacre incident. So to that point they have, we also think that, you know, the communalism and communal organizations which were being formed to protest, to get the interest of the communal, their problems, what are the sufferings they're having. So that was being started because in the Bengal was being divided from the year 1905, this communalism and communal organizations has been get formed. Next, in the yesterday's class, we have been discussing about the Khilafat agitation and the non-cooperation movement. Khilafat agitation, it has been going to relate with the same, the partition of the Bengal, with the, how they have been created, West Bengal, it is existing in India, and the West, East Bengal, present of the Bangladesh. The same like the situation, the British has been adopted the policy of the divided rule. Khilafat movement actually has been get started in the Turkey by the Ottoman Empire. The British has wanted to control the Central Asia part. So with this one, they have been gave a call of the country Swaraj. So that inspiration has been to by the Indian people, and in India also this non-cooperation movement was being started, and it was in a full fledged out from the year 1920. It was been of 1920, but 1921 it has been got a complete in its peak, like all the people there have started participating, the youth, school children, then at the same time, the lawyers who have been doing the practice, they gave up their practices, joining this non-cooperation movement. And during this period of time only the charkha, the weed, or the spinning of the cloth has been made, self-reliant to the Indian people, and this have been get started, and they have been declared the 26th January as the day of the Purna Swaraj in 1930. Next, from the March of 1930, the government has been made, the British government had the laws which have been made on the salt. So to break the salt law, they have been started a movement called Salt Satyagraha from the year 1932 to 1942.
Saba.
Sabarmati ashram, the way he used to stay, from it reached to Dandi, 375 kilometers, and by walking to 24 days along with the 70 companions, with the followers. So as he was moving from Sabarmati ashram to till Dandi, who the officers, the people who have been working as a government officials, the people were resigning from their jobs and joining in this Swachhagraha movement. So they went to the Dandi sequestered place. He took the handful of salt and he has been broke the salt. And this has been now as a symbol that Indian people have been not, they have been refused to live under the British law and to get the British rule. So a wave of enthusiasm swept the country. Salt laws were broken in many places. Even women took part in civil disobedience movement. In Delhi alone, 1600 women were imprisoned. This movement was not confined to the salt satyagraha alone. Foreign cloth shops and liquor shops were picked and burned. Hand spinning was taken up the movement. British schools, colleges and services were boycotted. The people joined in this movement in large number. So in this movement, it is not only about the salt satyagraha to break the salt laws. And to the surprise one, not only the men, even the women has also been participating in the movement. So in this movement, when they were being the women, at this time, nearly 1600 women were imprisoned in the place of Delhi. And after that one, they started burning out the foreign cloth, then liquor shops, all and boycotting the British schools, colleges, educational institutions, and giving services to the British. All it was to get happened in spite of going the salt satyagraha movement. And this movement has become a very good way that many people, irrespective of any differences, they were made participating, and that too in very large number. The government replied with ruthless repressions, lathi charges, and firing on the unarmed crowds of men and women. Over 19,000 satyagrahis, including Gandhi and other Congress leaders, were imprisoned. 110 persons were killed and over 300 wounded in police fight. Restrictions were imposed on press. The British attempted to divide the Indians by winning over Muslims, Zamindars and other minorities to its side. But the leaders took up constructive program throughout the country, like wearing khadar, a removal of untouchability to bring social cohesion in the movement. In response to the call of Gandhi, a number of women broke vada and participated in the movement. So during this period of time, the movement was growing in a very large number. So British, they wanted to control the movement in what way? Very ruthless manner, humanity type of treatment, inhuman type of treatment, opened the firing to the unarmed people. Unarmed people means those who were not having any weapon to protect themselves with any harm. So all the people, they started the firing and many people were killed, wounded. So during this period of time, nearly 90,000 satyagrahis and along with the Gandhi and along with the Congress leaders, they were imprisoned. Means they have a nearly, you can say, of the lack of people they have with the Congress officials, the Britishers, they have been imprisoned, the Gandhi and the other many thousands of the leaders. In that one capital, more than 100 people were killed and more than 300 people were killed, wounded. So in this one, the British again they have been using a policy of divide and rule. In this one, they were giving, trying to take the control of the minorities. Minorities is the people who have been less in number when compared to the in terms of the majority of the other religion. So Zamindars, by giving the money or by giving the lands or something on the grants, they want to take the support of The British refused to concur the demand. The Commerce Ministry resigned in protest. So 1935, after this protesting movement, all this has been happened. The 1935 Government of India Act. Government of India Act, which it deals with providing provincial autonomy.
USA occupied the Berlin of Italy, and USSR Russia has drawn
Bombay and Madras resolution stating clearly that British rule in India must end immediately. That evening, after the first India resolution was passed, Mahatma Gandhi addressed these memorial words to the Indian people. Every one of you should form this moment onwards, considering yourself as a free man or woman and act as if you are free. I'm not going to be satisfied with anything short of complete freedom. We shall do or die. We shall either free India or die in the attempt. In the early years of 9 August 1942, the government arrested most of the Congress leaders like Gandhi, Patel, Nehru, Maulana Azad, Acharya Kripalani, Rajendra Prasad and others. The people protest with hartals, strikes, processions all over the country. Unfortunately, the movement turned violent. The working class in the factories boycotted the work and the students attacked the police stations, post offices, railway stations and other public places. They cut off telegraph and telephone wires and railway lines. They burned government buildings, vehicles, military vehicles, railway carriages. Madras and Bombay were the most affected in this respect. The British authorities disappeared in the parts of Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Odisha, West Bengal, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh. In Midnapur, people set up panel government during 1942 to 1944. As a result of this movement, 10 lakh pounds of property was destroyed. 30 police personnel and 10 army lost their lives. Many people were killed. Thousands were arrested in the government suppression. By the end of 1943, over 90,000 people were arrested and around 1 lakh killed in the police fighting. In many years, in many areas, orders were given to machine gun crowds from airplanes. The rebellions, however, ultimately brought the British Raj to its knees. So, 1942, in the year, same 1942, in the procession of the Bombay, the Congress has been passing clearly the resolution that the British need to quite quit the Indian government, Indian rule immediately. So, to that point, Mahatma Gandhi gave a call of do or die, in that he said to every Indian that you are men or women, you need to be free, and if you are being free, you are going to come here, you are going to participate in the national movement. And due to the, by the slogan do or die, it means that we will do or we shall die for the country to get and take the freedom. So, immediately for the 8th August, this resolution has been given to us. Next day, 9th of August 1942, Congress has been arrested the important Congress leaders, Gandhi, Nehru, Patel, then Sardar Vallabhbhai Prasad, all they were being arrested. And immediately, this movement, instead of turning into the non-violence, way non-violent, it turned out to be a very violent. And in that way, they have been boycotted the work, the students boycotted the schools, colleges were boycotted by the students, police stations were attacked, post offices were attacked, railway stations were attacked, the telephone wires, telephone lines, railway tracks were being completely cut off, and the people, demonstrators, they were burned the police vehicles, police buildings, military vehicles, the railway which they carry, the carriages, the weapons. So all the equipment got affected, burning everywhere, complete violence was being started. This was most affected the Madras and the Bombay. And by seeing all this, from the many places of the India, like Uttar Pradesh, central part of India, then Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, all these places, the British officials, the British rule has been disappeared. So this movement was being continued from 1948 to 1944. And in this 10-year period of time, the British, they were using nearly India's property of 10 lakh pounds. It was being get destroyed. 30 police personnel were killed, and nearly army people has also lost their lives. And thousands of government officials were suppressed or they were suspended. And in the year 1943, 90,000 people were arrested. Nearly more than 1 lakh people were killed in this one. And to the more of crowded places when the officials cannot control, to that places the British, they had been ordered the use of airplanes from there. The air, this one guns, they can use to drop, like gun drop from the airways. So in this way, but ultimately the British government has been came on the knees because so much of violence that has been took place in the country. And during this period of time only, the Subhash Chandra Bose, but more, the Swaraj's leader has taken into the era, and he